place. But the way the weather's been going, we've had four of them that had been snowed out over the last 2 weeks. So it's been an interesting thing. So this is one that fortunately made it through the snow, and we're ready to go here today. I'm going to be working the warm-up that you got, and banddirector.com is going to make this, put this on their video clinic book kind of thing to kind of demonstrate to other schools that may be interested in looking for a warm-up. And I understand that you've done one similar to this in the past. Okay, so we're dealing with kind of familiar ground for you. Okay, I'm going to just kind of give you a couple like preambles to the whole reason that this exists. As when I was introduced, they said I was a high school band director, and I was a high school band director for a long time. And then I taught at George Mason University after that. And part of when I was a high school band director, I came up with this warm up. With help from the people that did my brass section for private lessons, sectionals, marching band, the whole thing. So this kind of evolved, and it actually evolved in part through a couple things with guys from the Garfield Cadets way back when. And it was modified, it's been tweaked and kind of put together, and it's been something that I've worked with for a long time. And the whole context is this. The idea was to take the best practices, that they call them, of what is the best thing for brass players to do to warm up. What do woodwind players need to do to warm up? And to some degree, percussion. Okay, and percussion, we just went with the mallet stuff. And the reason we went with the mallet stuff for percussion was that most of the time, percussionists avoid mallets like the plague, you know. And so we figured we're not going to give them an option of doing anything else, and just increase their mallet technique. And actually, one of the guys that was in the section that I, when I was first started this whole thing, is now a percussionist with the Cleveland Orchestra. So he went through this with me, and whether it got him to the Cleveland Orchestra, I'm sure it didn't, but he was one of the people that we helped work out part of this with too. Okay, so the warm-up is kind of taking what's best practices for brass instruments, woodwinds, and percussion, and put it together. Now, it, you know, when you play it together, it, you know, you wouldn't want to play it on a concert, or people would be heading for the doors really quickly, because in a musical standpoint, it doesn't have anything to do with it. But the warm-up part of it is critical, okay? If you are committed to becoming the best musician you can be, okay, if you're committed to that, and I would hope that you are, okay, you may have another career goal of becoming a nuclear physicist or something like that. But the point is that when you're in the room with your instrument, okay, when you're in a room with your instrument, whether it's at home practicing or it's in band, your commitment to your instrument is that you should become the best that you can possibly be, okay? It doesn't matter whatever you're going to do. It's that commitment to excellence that's going to carry you further in life. That, like Sam Palafian was saying earlier, okay? That's part of it, and this is part of that. So if you're gonna become the best you can be, these are the things that you need to be able to do, okay? So let's start off with the buzz warm-up, okay? And the brass players, you're just gonna use your mouthpieces. And I read an interesting article. There's a professional magazine called The Instrumentalist, and they interviewed Chris Martin. And Chris is currently the first trumpet player in the Chicago Symphony, the premier brass gig in the world. Okay, you don't get any better than principal trumpet player in the Chicago Symphony. Okay, so they ask him, what do you do? And he said, every day, because his job depends on it, I buzz for at least a half an hour. Okay, at least a half an hour. Every day. So if Chris Martin in that position is taking the pains to go through this whole buzzing thing, there must be something to it, okay? And there was also a trombone player in the the Chicago Symphony many years ago. His name was Edward Kleinhammer. And his thing was that he used to, when he was driving from home to the Chicago Symphony rehearsals, while he was in traffic, he buzzed his mouthpiece. My only comment would be, I can only imagine what some guy pulling up next to him on the thruway going into Chicago is wondering, what is this guy doing with that hunk of metal in his face? You know, driving 60 miles an hour on the thruway could be kind of interesting. Anyway, so let's do this, okay? The woodwinds are going to play the pitch. And woodwinds, you are not just a tone generator, okay? This is your opportunity to start your day correctly, okay? The breathing stuff, embouchure, listening to yourself, okay, and listening to your neighbors is all part of this. Don't just play, okay? Play with a purpose, okay? Here we go. Woodwinds are first. Let's take a good breath and go. Fuller sound, woodwinds, fuller sound. Fill your horns up, woodwinds. Good. Okay, can we do this? Brass players, I see some of you doing this, and I applaud you for doing this. You're holding the mouthpiece with the tips of your fingers, okay? That's what you want to do. You do not want to press that mouthpiece up against your face and apply a lot of pressure. So if you're grabbing the mouthpiece like this, especially the lower brass instruments, don't do that, okay? Just hold it with your fingertips, okay? Let's start all over again, okay? Woodwinds, be concerned with your sound. That's why you're doing this. Ready? And take a breath. Lower woodwinds play out more. Stop. Before you go on, brass players, I'm hearing some of you are tonguing as you get up a little higher. Resist the temptation. Just buzz. Okay, woodwinds, we're going on. Okay? Right where you left off. Breathe. Excellent. And I also want to compliment you on one other thing that you did that I appreciate you doing. Especially the woodwinds, when you got to the ends of these little phrases, you held the last note out with full value, no matter what it was. That's a sign that you've had some good training. Okay? Little thing, right? Detail work. That's what we're talking about. Okay? All right. Brass players, put your mouthpieces on. And here we go. Now this is the lip slur part. Okay? And the woodwind players like the first measure, not so much the second measure, right? Right? When we get into a concert, fun and games. Now, here's what you're doing. brass players, the next logical step in your warming up process after the buzzing, okay? Lip slurs, okay? As we start out, the first lip slur is just descending from tonic to dominant to tonic down at the bottom. And then we're going down the progression of fingerings as you go down. Woodwinds, you're going through scales, okay? Brass players, the lip slurs develop flexibility, endurance, and above all, tone quality, okay? The same way you buzzed your mouthpiece when you did the buzzing is the same application here, okay? You don't want to use any push on your pressure on your lip, right? Let the lips buzz, let the buzzing make the sound, okay? Woodwinds, your thing now is developing technique, okay? The better you can play your scales, and the brass players should be doing this in some other way, but for now, for the woodwinds, as a woodwind player, your technique is a critical part of what you do, okay? Getting around the horn as fast as you can, right? This is what you're practicing now. The better you can play your scales, especially the scales that are less frequently played, notice I did not say harder, okay? They're not harder. They're the same 8 notes in the scale. It's just a different combination. So don't look at them as being harder. They're less familiar, okay? And this will help you become familiar with them, okay? Here we go. Let's just do the brass players first, and then woodwinds you can finger along, and we'll get to you in a minute, all right? Brass players, let's go with this thing, okay? Ready? And take a good-sized breath. Ready? Fill the horn up. Fill the horn up, right? Going on, go. Even more, move your air. Move the air, okay? Go. Use the third valve slide if you have it on the next one. Go. Let's do that one again. Ready? The last one again. Right? Go. Right. The worst out-of-tune combination on a brass instrument. You've got the lip down. Get the third valve, trumpet players especially, but lip down, it's sharp. All right, try one more time, the last one. Go. Okay, sing that for me, okay? Sing that for me, go. Okay, a little low for you, all right? Try it again, one more time. Put your horn up, get ready to play, but sing it first. Wah, here's the pitch. Go, sing it. Now play that pitch. Just the first note. Sing the first note again. Good, now play it. Match the pitch. Right, that should take some practice. You need to be able to play that better in tune, right? Sometimes if you think of blowing the air into the bottom of the mouthpiece, it brings the pitch down. Try it one more time. Wah. Sing it again. Go. Good. Now play it. Watch it. Yeah, better, better, better. Not perfect, but better. Okay, everybody now. Woodwinds, join the fun, right? Beginning. First buzz warm-up. Ready? Go. Mm-hmm. I'm going a little faster. Fuller sound, woodwinds. Even more woodwinds. Blow down. Next one. Okay, let's go right into the next one. All right, ready? Percussion are going to join us now, right? Mallets? Did they get parts? Oh, you never get them? Okay, all right. All right, you got off easy. Okay. Okay. Yeah, here we go. You got off easy. We'll get to that in a minute. Here we go. We're playing number two now, okay? Ready? Go. Fill the horn up. Good. The next one? Ready? The next one. Good. All right. Take a little breath. Take a little break. Let's play the next one, woodwinds only. Okay? Next one for the woodwinds only. Ready? Breathe. Clarinets, fingerings. I'm watching a couple of you. You're doing a good job with alternating the pinkies. Okay, some of you are not, but some of you don't do. Okay, brass players. Let's hear you guys do this. Okay. Breathe. Right, brass players, now that you're going up more frequently, avoid the temptation to tongue as you're going up. It's all lip slurs, okay? Let's all start at the beginning of this one now. Ready? A few wrong notes there. Go on. That's okay. Good. Brass players, let's play the next one. Okay. Just a couple measures. Ready? breathe. Good. Avoid the temptation to tongue the higher notes. Go. Okay, good. Woodwinds, let's play the first couple measures. Ready? Woodwinds only. Ready? Let's try that again. Let's stay together. Ready? Ready, and go, and. Good. Together, everybody now? Everybody. Ready? Go. Players. Stretch there, huh? Okay, good. Yeah, you'll get better at those as the more you do them. Okay, all right, good. Now, can we do one more thing, please? This is number four now, right? Okay, can you do number four again, please? Ready? Number four. It's like rehearsal number four. Okay, ready? Go. Good. Now, woodwinds. The first time you do that scale, it's all slurred. Yes? The second time, it's all tongued. Okay? Do not slur the second time through. The reason it's tongued the second time is to help you gain more speed articulation and getting your fingers and tongue together at a faster speed. Okay? So don't be misled to think that you slur the whole thing. Slur the first time through, tongue the second. Okay, should we try that again, please? Number four from the beginning. Ready? Okay, that's just for future reference. Okay? You did a great job with it. You only had this for a few days, right? A few days to go through it. The thing for the woodwinds is getting better at the scales. Okay, obviously. Okay, and that's going to help you a lot. And brass players being able to do that, it would be interesting to hear some of you play it individually to make sure that you're slurring everything. Okay, because that's the critical thing for you guys. Okay, the whole thing, by the way, if you do the whole warm-up, I'm going to say takes about 12 minutes to get through the whole thing. Okay, going from one to the next, no stops, straight through. 12 minutes, which is a great investment in your tone, flexibility, scale knowledge, articulation, endurance, and tone. Okay. So that's basically the whole idea on the warm-up. All right, good. So we're going to do some of your band music now, and I think there may be a little hitch here in the time. Do you have scores? I don't know if they meant, did they mention that my, where I taught first, my first job? Here was, my first job, first teaching job was close to where you are, you guys are. You're not far from Ambler, are you? No, you're not? You're pretty close or not? Or am I thinking of some other school? Okay, all right, good.
We're gonna have you go outside and visit.
Okay, cool.
And, I'm gonna visit with you just for a few minutes, five or less.
Okay.
And, Tom Merrill is waiting for you outside.
Okay, and cool, all right.
My fault, I opened the wrong door. I opened the broom closet.
Okay. God, how many percussion you guys have? You have your own army back here, man. Okay. Oh. Am I using this?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. We're ready.
All right, great. Thank you.
Okay. Good. Let's start at the beginning. Right? See what happens. Okay. Let's do the Alfred Reed second suite for band. Yeah. Go ahead. We're just gonna play a minute or two of it just to kind of see where you are with this. Okay, here we go. Beginning. First movement, ready? One. Okay. One is a rest for everybody, okay, right? So I'm giving you one. Ba-liam. Have you been practicing it in 4/4 or cut time? In cut time? Yeah, okay, all right, here we go. Same place, ready? 1. Okay. Okay, good. Nice. Good clarinet sound. All right, here we go. I notice some buffets in the front row and some good mouthpieces. That all makes a difference. Okay, here we go. Beginning again. Ready? 1. Bum, bum. First cornets, first trumpets. Wait a minute. Okay, first cornets are here, and the first trumpet, you and the Phantom. Okay, you and the Phantom, and then your cornet, trumpet, and okay, all right, so now we've got that. And where's first horn? Good. Okay, one person on first horn. And then, okay, and then first alto, right here, first alto, okay. Okay, good. All right, I'm kind of looking to figure out where I'm hoping to cue you from with and so forth, okay? Let's go back to the beginning one more time. You've got a good grasp on the style of this, okay? It sounds like you've played Mexican music before, so you've got a pretty good grasp of it. It's pretty nicely, okay? Here we go. One more time, beginning. Let me hear the first note and hold it, okay? Ready? Go. The sound that you just played right now as a single note was a much more convincing sound than what you did before, including the warm-ups, okay? I like what you just played, okay? I like that more. You were moving the air better. You were filling the horns better. Keep doing that, okay? All right, here we go. Beginning. Ready? 1. Let me try something. Can I hear everybody but the flutes, clarinets, oboes? Yeah, everybody else but those people. So you guys are not going to play. Ready? Ready? 1. Yeah, I need to hear more out of the trumpet part and the cornets and the trombones in measure 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm not hearing bum 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 bum. I'm not hearing that at all. Okay? All right. One more time for the beginning. Okay? 1. Okay. I'm still not hearing what I want to hear. One more time. Ready? Same group of people. Ready? Go. 1. Now I know what I'm hearing. Okay, saxophones. Ba, wa, dum, bum, bum. Each one of those figures starts on the beat. Okay, you're anticipating it every time. So you're constantly getting further and further ahead of me. Okay, here we go. One more time, same group. And the trumpets, you're right in with them also. bum, beep, ba, beep, ba, beep, ba. Start on one each time, okay? And actually tongue the note harder on one, okay? Ready? One. Better. I got. I have a figure. I'm going in a. Am I going slower than what you did do? Okay. I'll crank it up a little bit. I'll try to come to your tempo a little bit better. Okay. So we're not. We don't have as many issues with that. All right. We'll get rid of the problem. Me. Okay. There we go. Everybody now. Everybody. About that, like that. Here we go. Ready? And one. Ten, percussion. Can you play your parts out just a little bit more? Let me hear it. Percussion. Ready? Go. Yeah, the tom-tom, bump-bump, bop-bop, beep-bop, or whatever you're playing, play it out more. Okay? One more time, percussion. Ready? Good job, though. Ready? Go. And. Good, good. Everybody at 10 now? 10. The biggest thing, if I were to have to stop now and give you a concluding comment to what I would say to you as something that I would hope that you would think about a little bit more, and that is to be a more independent player, okay? When you're in a group this size, there's safety in waiting for somebody else to play a part and then following along behind them. Okay, you need to be more independent about that, because when you're following somebody on a part like that, you're behind. Okay, you're behind them. So if you're more independent about your own parts, the entrances will be cleaner, the attacks will be cleaner. Okay, and it will sound much more confident. Don't be afraid. Count your part and go. Okay, 10, first time through. You're all capable of doing it. Okay, 10. Ready? 2, and. Good. Woodwinds and brass. Did you remember when I had the percussion play by themselves? Okay. When you're playing your part here at 10, you've got to be constantly locked in on what they're doing. They're laying a pulse down for you, okay? And every once in a while, we kind of get a little bit unglued, but if you were listening to them, you would hear where the pulse is, okay? There's an inner pulse in every piece of music that translates and covers the whole piece of music, okay? There's an inner pulse, so this is... Okay, it's a subdivision of the beat, and that's what holds it together. And that's what you need to do. When you're playing this, if you're thinking da 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 da, there's no guarantee you'll ever be able to play that together cleanly. But if you're thinking da 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 ba bum ba 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 da, don't think of beats. Think of beats and upbeats. One and two and one and two and one and two, and that'll hold it together better. You can lock into the tempo better. So don't just think one, two, one, two. Never, okay? Never. I don't care if you're playing Second Suite, Beethoven Fifth Symphony, whatever you're playing, okay? Okay, subdivided beat is where the answer is. Okay, here we go. We're at 10, first time through, and I promise not to stop you till we at least get to 20. All right, here we go. 10, first time through. Listen back to the percussion. Ready? Okay. trumpets. Play that muted part for me. One, two, three, go. And. Good. What kind of mute do you have? A fiber? And you have a fiber one? And you have a metal. Okay, this, you're getting two different sounds out of the section because you have the fiber, Humes and Berg, right? Humes and Berg mutes, and then the, they look like crowns. Are they crowns? Okay. This, you want to all have the same kind of mute, okay, so you can match the sound better. Does anybody else have an extra mute they're not using now, like a metal one? And maybe you just borrow one for a couple minutes? Oh, you have more of the Humes and Berg red flashy ones? Yeah? You don't have them? Okay. All right. Put that in your budget. Okay? Right? One less trip to McDonald's. Okay? Go for the bargain menu, you know, the double cheeseburger for a buck, and buy yourself a metal mute. Okay? All right? Here we go. We're at, I said I wouldn't stop, didn't I? But I lied again. Okay? It's just like your band director always says, one more time, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, right? Yeah. We actually take classes in that in college, you know, about, you know, like kind of telling the truth, but not really, you know, that's one of them. One more time, just one more time, right? Okay, 10 second time through. 10 second time through, okay? All right, 24, no melody. 24, ready? One, here we go. 24, go. Horns, don't be afraid of it. Play it out more, okay? One more time, same people, same place. 24, accompaniment only. Ready? Go. Good. Excellent. Excellent. I want you guys on this side of the room, when you're playing that part, to listen to what else is going on this side. This is like a small ensemble, like a chamber music group, okay, like a quintet kind of, right? And you are one group that has its own entity versus the melody, okay? And you've got to play it like it's an important part. Right now, I'm kind of thinking that you're not really thinking, well, we're just playing, you know, blah, blah, whatever. It's an important part. Don't be afraid of it. Play it out with a good sound, right? The sound that you use in the beginning of the rehearsal, right? Not the other one. All right? 24 again. No melody yet. Okay? Without this part, the melody is boring. You add the life to it. Okay? So play it that way. Okay? 24. Ready? Good. Put it all together. Nice job, baritones, especially the crescendo that you played there at the end. Thank you. Keep doing that, okay? We're at 24, everybody. Clarinets, remember the scale stuff at the beginning of the warm-up? This is where it comes into play, the measure before this. Be-da-da-da-da-da-dum, right? Okay? Here we go. Let's play that. This is one before 24. One before 24. Ready? And. Good. 4 before 40. How many of you have an eighth note and nothing else in the measure, then an eighth note, nothing else in the measure, eighth note? Good. Can I hear that? Okay. Play the first eighth note and with a nice sound, with a nice full sound. Go. Hold it. Hold it out. Go. Right. That is not anywhere near the sound you played when the full band was playing. Okay? Play that sound now and play the short sound. Bump, bump, set, play it. Okay, ready? Use that sound, but when you play it short. Okay, ready? Go. Right, good. Add a little more length to the note. Ta, ta, ta. Say the syllable T-A-H, not T-U-T. Ta, ta, right? One, two, with a good sound. Right, take it up a notch volume-wise. Take it up a notch volume-wise. Ready? Ready? Go. More. 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 Good. It says crescendo, yes? Right? Gradually getting louder, okay? Back to 24. I mean, one before 24. One before 24. Nice job, woodwinds. Ready? One before 24. Ready? Good. Good. Woodwinds, read around your notes. What does it say below your notes? Crescendo? Does it say start soft? Can you do that? Okay. Be-da-da-da-da-da-da-dum, right? Yes. Read what's on the page. Yes. Ready? Everybody, one before 24. And. Good. 58. 58. Can I hear the woodwinds, please? Flutes, really. Flutes and saxes, right? Nice job. Measure before. Can we try that again? Let me hear it again. One before 58. Flutes and alto saxes. One, two, three, go. One. Right. Listen. Ba-da-da-dee-da-da-da-dum. Right? Ready? Good. Look, everybody, look through your parts. How many times do you have the figure half note triplets? Okay, like the woodwinds, you just played it at 60, right? Do you see that? How many of you have that? Raise your hand. Okay. How many times, when you have that, how many times does that have an accent on it? Does it ever have an accent? Okay. Actually, if you want to make that rhythm more effective, play it with a little more weight, kind of an accent. Do, 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 do. You kind of exaggerate the three against two. Okay? You have three notes spread over two beats. Dee, da, da, dum. Okay? All the way through this piece. Okay? No matter where it is, just put a little accent there. How about starting before 58, everybody? One, two, three, four, five, six measures. Everybody? Okay? And. Okay, good. Wait a minute, wait. Play those notes one at a time. Okay, here's the downbeat. Right. Let me hear the people that play. Bum, 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 bum. Okay, ready? Go, one note at a time. Right. Right. Now let me hear everybody else. Okay? Go. Right. The melody is up here. This is a contrasting part, but it gets lost, okay? You can play that out more. It's a contrasting part, okay? Try it together. All together, everybody. Ready? Go. Right. Play that part out even more yet, okay? One more time. Even more. Take a breath, fill the horn up. Ready? Go. Right, fill the horn up. Okay, everybody. Bum, bum, beep, bum, bum. Like that. Ready? Go. And. Even more. You get lost. You're getting lost. Try it again. Go. And. Good. Everybody now. Back to 4-0. 40. Ready? Good. Okay. 40. You're getting a little looser with this. I guess you're maybe getting used to me now, which has some part of it too, okay? You can open up a little bit more with this, okay? Don't be quite so afraid, right? I haven't killed anybody. I guess it's been 2 weeks now, so you're safe. Come on, play out more, okay? 40, okay? I did hurt a few people, but that doesn't count, right? Okay, all right, here we go. 40, ready, go, and. Good horns. Trumpets. Trumpets. I'm looking at the score. I see notes. I look back at you. I see horns in your face. You look like you're playing, but I can't hear you, okay? Trumpets are supposed to be loud, louder than what you guys are, okay? Play out more, okay? Right? Let me hear that part of the trumpets, right? Starting at 58, trumpets and cornets that have this part. 1, 2, 3, go. Have you ever heard that before? Have the saxes. Have you ever heard that before? That's bad. That's not good. Okay, they're right in front of you. How do you expect your mom to hear it in the back of the hall? Okay, she's been paying for trumpet lessons for you for years, right? She wants to hear you play. You know, grandma maybe even, okay? All right, here we go. Trumpets again, ready? You can play out, okay? Ready? Go. Good. Now can we play it together? 1, 2, bop, bop, bop. Get the first three notes together. Ready? Go. You're not together. You're not together. Ready? Go. And. Good. A little bit more? Okay. A little bit more? Yes? Okay. How about a lot more? 1, 2, play it so that I have to tell you, no, it's not that loud. Okay? Ready? Go. Good. That's the right volume. Okay. All right? Here we go. We're at 58. Right? And make sure that's nice and crisp, too. 58. Ready? 1, 58. Ready? Here we go. Good. Good. Did you remember the accents? Dee da da dum. More weight on the notes. More weight on the triplets. Okay. 58 again. Okay. That's important to this style. 58. 1, 2. Here we go. And. trombones. I see your part on my score. I see the horns up in your face. I don't hear you. Okay, what kind of mutes are we playing on? Yeah, those are good door stoppers. Okay, right, you want to upgrade to the metal ones. Okay, that'll be a better sound. Those things always, to me, sounded like you had a rag stuffed in the horn. Okay, the metal mutes, they're metal, so they give you a little bit more bite to the sound. Okay, again, go for the McDonald's bargain menu, right? A couple times, you have to do it a couple times, they're a little more expensive, okay? 74. Actually, if you stop at a McDonald's on the way home tonight, the woodwinds will buy you burgers, so you can save your money for a mute, okay? Oh, wait a minute, shh, hold it. The percussion have just said they'd rather do it. So the percussion section. Okay. All right. 74, you need a new bass drum mallet too. Here we go, 74, here we go, 74. You've done a great job of doing what I'm asking you. Keep doing it, okay? Play it out more. Let me hear it once. Ready? One, two, three, go. Good. Let me ask you something. Which do you think is the more important part? The part that goes dot 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 dot, or the part that goes dot 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 dot? Which one? B is the right answer. Okay? All right? Here we go. Play it again. Trombones? Ready? Okay. Is there some reason the rest of you aren't playing? You just don't have mutes or what? Is that what it is? Okay. All right. Here we go. You need to have a fundraiser. Have a car wash, right? And buy the trombones mutes. Here we go. Okay? 74. Now's a good time for a car wash, too. Here we go. Here we go. 74. Ready? Go. Good, good, good. That should cut through. Okay, we're at 74, everybody. Don't forget the accents over here on the triplets. Over here, I'm sorry. Ready? 74, ready? Let me hear that mallet part. One, two, three, go. Right. Good. If it's possible, play that out a little bit more. That would work too. Okay. We're at 74. Okay. 74. Everybody. Ready? Oh. Shh. You know what happened? What happened? You got ahead. Right? Put that first note on the downbeat. Yup, up, up, but up, up, but up, but up, bum. Okay? 74, ready? I've gone back to my tempo, and you're used to going faster. So try to come back with me, okay? 74, ready? Ninety. Okay, there are all kinds of interesting rhythm things going on in here that are not coming through. Okay, 90. Okay, 90. Ready? Ready? Okay, let's do something differently, okay? We'll go on to the next movement, okay? All right, this may take some getting used to, okay? Okay, here we go. How long have you rehearsed this piece? 2 months? Since the holidays, right? You started after the holidays? Okay, all right, good. All right, here we go. Who's gonna play the solo? Okay.
He wasn't conducting the first part.
Right, it's all yours. All right, here we go, go. Okay, third measure. I'll go with you. Okay, third measure. Ready? I'll tell you what, let's try something. Go back to the third measure. Go back to the third measure. I'm going to start you, and I'm going to let you just play. I'm not going to conduct. Okay? Third measure. Go. Slowly, right where it says slowly, same thing. Ready? Same place. Go. Okay. 11. 11? I'm just going to start you. 11. Go. One more time at 11. 11. I'm not going to conduct. You're going to play. Ready? Go. In. Okay, tell me what difference you heard, this, maybe the second or even the first time you played it without a conductor. What did you hear that was different? You listened around more? Okay, what else? They weren't what? Okay, what else? Speak up a little bit more.
Since we had to listen to other instruments, it was more balanced.
Yes. That is an incredibly important lesson for you to learn. Okay? The other thing that happened is you didn't have any choice but to take ownership for that section. Right? You took ownership for that piece. Some of you played the dynamics much better than you did the first time. Because you were taking ownership, okay? Let's do it again, okay? Try it again. We're at, what is it? 11. 11, okay? Incredibly important lesson. Ready? Go. Yeah, okay? Listen, conductors, okay, are supposed to help you facilitate what you're doing, okay? You shouldn't have to depend on us for everything, okay? You have your own brain, right? You probably don't share it with the person next to you, okay? You probably are independent enough. That's what you need to do, though. Take ownership of the piece. Let me help you, okay? My biggest job is to stand up here and look good. Well, sometimes it doesn't always work that way, but, you know, that's my job, right? I'm just supposed to look good. Conductors are here for, you know, just to get you started, right? Yes, no, okay. All right, here we go. We're at 11, okay? 11. Nice job on the vibes part. Keep that coming. You know what? Do you have any softer mallets? Let me hear the part with that. Yeah, and don't dampen. Don't dampen. Yeah, try it again. Yeah. Good. And do this. De-da-da-da. I'll exaggerate. Dee-da-da-da-dee-da-da-da-dum. As you're going down? Yeah, right. 11? Those notes will get lost if you don't do that. 11? Listen around. Go. Think would make that sound more, make it more fun to play? That whole melody part. What do you think? More what?
Phrasing.
More phrasing? Okay. Are you doing it now? Little bit? Little bit? Yeah, it's not coming across. Okay? You have to exaggerate that kind of stuff, right? Right? Just read what's on the page because he wrote in everything you need to know. Okay? He doesn't leave much to question. Okay, all right. We're back at 11 one last time, right? 11. Good, trombones. Listen, as you're doing this, if you see a conductor making a bigger gesture, right, don't just change your dynamics this much, okay? Overdo it, okay? Right now, you're kind of playing the dynamics, but if I were sitting out there listening to what you're playing, I would not recognize the fact that you are doing the crescendos and diminuendos. Okay, if it's not, it's kind of like, you know, have you all seen actors and actresses up close, right? Right? Like in your school plays and that sort of thing, in the drama department, when they put on makeup and it's like caked on their face. And when you're standing 2 feet in front of them, you're going, wow, that's pretty ugly, you know? Because they have the lipstick on, you know, like up to their nose, you know, and out to here, kind of like a clown, all right? And you look, you know, why do they do that? Well, if you're in the audience and you're sitting out in the cheap seats all the way up top, all of a sudden, those oversized, exaggerated makeup things look natural, okay? It's the same thing when you play. Where you think you're doing a crescendo, do, 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 is not going to translate out there, okay? It's not going to translate out there, okay? What you're trying to do when you play any kind of a musical piece, what you're trying to do more than anything else, and Sam Playfian said this when he was up here talking at the very beginning when everybody was sitting in the audience about telling a story, okay? If you're trying to tell the story of this tango, and you're only doing it like this much, it's not going to come across. Okay? All right, I have an analogy for you. I've never used this before, so I may get in trouble. How many of you ever watched Dancing with the Stars? Right? The guys are afraid to put their hands up. We know you're watching it, guys. Right, thank you. Okay. All right. And all the girls are watching, cut their hands up. Yeah, I watch it, right? Do you ever see them do a tango on Dancing with the Stars? How would you describe a tango when they do it? But what kind of a feeling do you get when you watch the tango from them? It's what? Yes. Yes, it is. Okay? But this is what you're playing now is like da 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 da, no. Da-dee-ya, right? Try to inject a little bit more of yourself into a little more life into it, right? Don't wait for your neighbor to do it. You do it, okay? Right? Don't make it a timid kind of a thing, all right? We're at 23, okay? Okay, 23. I'm going to let you play it. Ready? Here we go. I'm going to let you start. Ready? Go. Good. Okay, let's go a little faster with it. Okay, we're at 23 again. Ready? 1, 23, and. Okay, all right. My time is up with you. You now get the real treat. Right, you get the real treat. You're going to work with Dr. Cetatol, okay? You're in for something very special. So I hope you take advantage of it. It was fun working with you. Hopefully you learned something, okay? It was fun, and you're a fine group of young men and women, and keep up the good thing. Represent Springford High School, rah-rah, okay? Okay, good for you. Okay, good.